it actually means passion. You know, like all Indians are passionate about the game. It all started in Mumbai, where I think cricket was at its most passionate. We've got about 30 to 35,000 registered players with the Mumbai Cricket Association. And that, I think, is a large amount in the whole country. But for all Mumbaikers, it's the gully cricket that started it all. And it's not as well played now because of the infrastructure being different. But during all these three or four decades that I've been associated with the game, I think cricket meant everything to the common man, the household families. Everybody was, you know, glued to cricket during test matches on the little transistor radios that they had then and even now. So cricket is like a way of life for a Mumbaiker. I must say that the Mumbai Cricket Association does a lot for the youngsters, for junior level cricket. They've got about 90 tournaments in the whole year. No city in the world has got 90 tournaments. And somehow or the other, the programming is so good that they manage matches. It's, you know, our season starts and ends. It starts somewhere in July with the Kanga League and it ends sometime in May, end of May, you see. So there's enough possibility. I know there's a dearth of grounds. I know there's a paucity of, you know, good wickets. But the amount, number of people that want to play this game, the Mumbai Cricket Association has got several programs to hone skills for cricketers. There are so many academies that everybody has. If you go on a Saturday or a Sunday or a Monday to Friday morning to all these grounds, you'll see the number of opportunities that youngsters get. There's always going to be a dearth of space. There's always, you know, in India, there's always a problem of finding grounds for sport. And unless and until sport is looked at in a different dimension, I mean, it'll remain the way it is. But the enthusiasm and the support of associations is not lagging behind at all. I mean, the demands are so big that the supply is not so much at all, you know. But because you have only six or seven grounds. All the same, I must also add that, you know, the game of cricket is now going into the suburbs. It's going as far as Virar, it's going as far as Kalyan, Thane. You know, all our cricket is shifting there. In the South Bombay, the cricket is not as much as it used to be. But everything is shifting towards that side. So the miles that have increased in the opportunities that are being given to cricketers is massive, really. But there is always a shortage. Always in Mumbai, like you love, for all of you and me, there's a shortage of space. Like in all metros, cricket has changed. You see, but the younger person has now different priorities. His priority is not to play the game alone because, you know, there is so much competition in life really for a youngster today that he has to choose. And it's not that you can make cricket a career, you see. You don't start off by playing cricket and decide to make it a career. A, you've got to have the talent in you, you've got to have the ball sense in you, and there are enough opportunities for people to develop their craft. But not all are successful. There are only a handful of people who are successful. So it's an intensely competitive sport where cricket in India and Mumbai in particular is concerned. You know, I think we need to sit and chat with some cricketers. I think we need to tell them that, you know, cricket hasn't changed. Cultures have changed, but the game has remained the same. I know there is a lot of, you know, facilities for cricketers, a lot of name that you can make out of cricket, but you got to come down to brass tacks. You've got to understand that the way to the top is nothing but hard work. Unfortunately, many kids, the way to the top is not hard work. And unless and until we imbibe that culture in Mumbai's cricket again today, you know, that'll be the thing. We'll have to appoint lots of TRDOs. You know, there are a lot of senior cricketers in Mumbai who need to go far and wide to see where the talent is and then get all these people together, start looking at this talent in a very, very, you know, individualistic way and sort out about 50, 60, 100 cricketers in Mumbai and then start a program for them. And as time goes along, find out if they're good at the higher level, give them better training. The academies need to work, you know, in tandem with each other. The coaching schemes need to be working in tandem with each other. And that's what the future of Mumbai's cricket could be. I think cricket administrators don't have as much opportunity, or shall I say, the facility to extend things. It's got to be the government. The government of Maharashtra must come in and start helping sport. Sport in toto, cricket in particular, because this city has a lot of cricket issues. And unless and until the Maharashtra government takes control over the grounds where lots of political rallies are held, lots of programs which are other than cricket are held, there's nothing more than we can do. The Mumbai Cricket Association is fighting for it for the last so many years to keep the grounds virgin for cricket. of a spot. That is not happening, and unless and until that happens, we are not able to go anything further. But unless also there is an issue of supply and demand. The supply and demand is so large, and all these morchas, all these issues, all the political rallies must stop at these maidans. Find some other place for them, pay heed to sport, make sport a compulsive subject, make sport an important subject of your life. You know, create people who play sports, allow people to develop for sports mentally. Like Sid said, cricket creates character. But if you don't give our youngsters the playground facilities, where are we going to get sport from? I think proper playing facilities is the first thing. You cannot play any sport unless you have proper playing facilities. For example, if you see international sport today, the kind of diving, the kind of fielding, if you look at Australia and England, you know, the kind of facilities that are there for, look, there are lesser number of people over there playing the sport, okay, but so be it. But there is enough grounds in India. Somebody has to take interest. The government has to take interest in looking after sport. My vision for Mumbai's cricket is, there's enough talent, try and hone it well. Give opportunities to youngsters and be dedicated and passionate about the sport. Unless you have the dedication and passion, administrators need to have dedication and passion to run a sport. If they have it, Mumbai's cricket is in good hands.